Doctor, can you help me? Cause I don't feel right. Better make it fast before I change my mind. Doctor, can you help me? Cause I don't feel right. Better make it fast before I change my mind. Well, it's cold, 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 cold inside. Darker in the day than the dead of night. Cold, 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 cold inside. Doctor, can you help me? Cause something don't feel right. Something don't feel right.
Good morning, Polly Parrots, and welcome to the very first episode of the Polly 10.
I'm Leslie.
And I'm Oscar.
And we're here to bring you the most talked about events that happened this past month.
And even the new exciting things in these upcoming weeks.
The Poly 10 is for you, the students and teachers here at Poly, and even produced by Poly students.
There are so many incredible things happening on campus every single day, and we know it's impossible to highlight everything.
But we will try our absolute best.
Hey Leslie, did you know that this show isn't the only thing new at Poly?
Really?
Yeah, we have a new principal, Ms. Vasquez.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
And even better, she was a student here at Poly.
Wow, tell me more about her.
How about we just go and meet her?
My vision for the school and what I want for the students is really for them to be prepared when they leave high school. For example, if you choose to go to college or a career, as long as you're ready and you're able to move up and be happy in what you're doing. Because I have such a strong team of administrators, coordinators, and teachers here, it's not as stressful as being a principal at maybe another site. But I am very fortunate to have family and friends outside of Poly that support me and make sure I'm able to relax by going to the movies. Sometimes I just tell Alexa to play some 90s music for me or just relaxing together over dinner. What made me come back to Poly, I wanted to teach math. And so I knew at the high school I can focus on teaching math. Aside from that, I was familiar with the school. I knew that at least on the first day of school, I would know where the restrooms were at because this was my high school. When I was a student here, I remember one of the differences is the number of counselors that we had on campus. And I would only go to my counselor for academic support to determine what classes I needed next. I would never go to them for other things which we have today, for example, social-emotional support or any other kind of assistance that I needed. I know today our students can go to their counselors and seek that help.
The things I do remember about Lydia was that she was extremely quiet, but a really sweet girl. And I do remember she had very, very long hair. She was one of those kids that never caused any kind of problems and did what she was supposed to do, so.
How was Ms. Vasquez as a student in my class? I remember her. She was very attentive to her work. She was very quiet. She got along great with everybody, but she was very, very, like they say in Spanish, muy aplicada, muy aplicada.
As a student, Ms. Vasquez was very quiet, but at the same time, you could tell she had goals, and she would set her goals, and she would go for them.
If I was to talk to the high school Lydia Vasquez today, I would say that she would never ever believe that I would be principal, and she would wonder why I would ever return to the school to hear the school bells early in the morning and all throughout the day. My parents came to the U.S. from Mexico with very little, and from that they were able to raise a family, buy a house, and send us to college. I know that their hard work, their dedication, their resourcefulness is what made a difference, and I picked up a lot of that. As the new principal, I would like to say to the Poly students that they have to keep all the doors open. They have to work hard to make sure that when they graduate, they have everything available to them, whether it's college or career.
Next, we have a quick look at Poly's varsity football team and their plan for success this season.
Well, last year, we had a rough year last year. I wasn't coaching last year because I had a hip replacement, but last year's team really struggled in a lot of areas. Hopefully we're a little bit better in those areas. we just had trouble offensively keeping the ball and defensively stopping the other team. So hopefully we made some changes this year. And we've got some good young kids from the JV team, so hopefully we'll kick some butt this year, I'm hoping. I just want that first win. Let's get that first win in so I can light up my victory cigar at home and enjoy it.
My name is Andrew Menegas, varsity captain, number 2, my receiver, cornerback. Last year, a lot of the guys think maybe we're a little bit scared. We had injuries, which killed us. A lot of guys kind of got hurt, so our like momentum kind of shifted downwards. Guys, we're eating in there, we're getting stronger, we're grinding together. Chemistry. This year we have a lot better, like a lot stronger chemistry than last year with us. We like get along together. We're able to work with each other, play with each other. So that's gonna help us a lot on the field. My expectation for this season is for us to come out strong. I think this year we'll have a lot better season than last year. Guys are hungrier. Expectations this year, just one common goal, city championship.
I'm Joey Sarate, I'm the quarterback for varsity and I'm the captain. You guys have probably heard some of the news around school that we got square season going on. Well, it's because I'm the square. This year, we're a stronger team together. One of the issues I thought we had last year was definitely the team chemistry. Last year, some of the seniors weren't the closest friends to some of the juniors. And this year, I made it for sure that we all hung out with each other. If it meant going to beat-ups together, if it meant going on the beach together, if it meant going to a friend's pool, at the end of the day, we're all together. We're all taking squad picks, and that's what really matters. And as far as predictions go, obviously everyone wants a championship ring. And I don't expect anything less for myself, and I think the team doesn't expect anything less of themselves.
And good luck to all of our incredible sports teams this year.
And now we'll visit the College Center. One of our amazing college counselors will tell us all the important information we need to know on this month's installment of
The College Minute.
Hi everyone, Miss Lewis here. I'm one of your 2 college counselors. Miss K is your other college counselor. And we just wanted to tell you about some upcoming events. On September 30th, we have the Senior Summit happening. This is your first major senior event, and we will be having a lineup of speakers there for you. We'll have college reps from the UCs and Cal States and Community College there to talk to you about the college application. And we're also giving away a free graduation ticket. For all of our 9th, 10th, and 11th graders, we will be having the PSAT. This is coming up on October 11th, and so we fully want you guys to get on Khan Academy and start practicing for this exam. This is kind of a prep for the real SAT, which you'll be taking your junior year, the spring of your junior year. And finally, guys, college application deadlines are happening on November 30th, so we will be calling you in to start working on those applications. Thanks for listening. Bye.
Before we end our first episode, we have an inspirational video made by one of our seniors, Alex, that shows Poly students at band camp this past summer.
And remember, teachers and students, if you have something great you want us to cover, please make sure to let us know. This has been your Poly 10,
and we'll see you in October.
You can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust in something, your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. Because believing that the dots will connect down the road will give you the confidence to follow your heart, even when it leads you off the well-worn path. And that will make all the difference. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. You've got to find what you love, and that is as true for work as it is for your lovers. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking, and don't settle. Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become.
But you're going to have some ups and you're going to have some downs. Most people give up on themselves easily. You know the human spirit is powerful. There's nothing as powerful. It's hard to kill the human spirit. Anybody can feel good when they have their health, their bills are paid, they have happy relationships. Anybody can be positive then. Anybody can have a larger vision then. Anybody can have faith under those kinds of circumstances. The real challenge of growth, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, comes when you get knocked down. It takes courage to act. Part of being hungry when you've been defeated, it takes courage to start over again. Fear kills dreams. Fear kills hope. Fear put people in the hospital. Fear can age you, can hold you back from doing something that you know within yourself that you're capable of doing, but it will paralyze you.